Thank you. Thank you. Good day, everybody. Welcome to Norway. Good morning, Kevin and Nick. Glad to see you're here flying along today. This is the final flight of our Norway tour. We're right up at the top of Norway. And then we're going to be heading across to basically the Russian border. Let me just pull it up so you can see where we are going. So we're over here. This part, we've just come up along the coast here, past Tromso into Alta, and then from here we're going to go across the north over the top of Sweden and then down here to Kirkenes or Kirkenes, and you can see it's right by the Russian border there, and that's going to do our tour of Norway. We'll be all the way up to the top. Good morning, Brian. How are you doing today? So that is the plan for today's flight. It's a little bit windy, a little bit cloudy. Not too bad here. Slightly windier over at our destination, but overall, not too bad. So, let's hop on board the aircraft, and we can start getting her all set up. All right, as per normal, we are in the Widerøe Twin Otter, and we'll start with our check. So, parking brake is set. Emergency fuel switches are both to normal. Fuel selector is set to normal. Fuel boost pumps are off. Radios are off. Cabin lights will come up top. We can get the fasten seat belt and no smoking lights on. We'll arm the emergency lights as well. We'll get the compartment fans up and going. We're going to set the anti-collision light on. Pitot heat is currently off, taxi lights are off, generator switches are off, flaps are up. Propeller levers are in feather, power levers are at idle, fuel levers are in cutoff. Ignition is normal, batteries on, and master switch is on. Still got that little sore throat, so please excuse any coughs if I don't get to the mute button in time. Well, hopefully I can provide you something a little bit relaxing today. So we're going to start the right engine. Boost pump will come on and start switch engaged. Engine rotation, adding fuel. So we got a good start on the right engine. Everything is looking good. Let's do the same for the left engine. We'll turn on the left boost pump and engine start. We have good rotation, adding fuel. Sounds good there as well. So torque pressures are good. Temperatures are good. RPMs are good. Pop power is good. Fuel flow is good. Everything is good there. So power levers are in idle. Generators can come on. Engines are within limits. Radios are both on. We'll put the transponder to standby. We are going up to a 19,000 foot cruise altitude, so we'll dial that in now. Compasses and gyros are all looking good and aligned. You can now come up. We'll put on the position lights. put our de-icer boots to auto. Pitot heat can come on. We'll put the heat on in the back on auto. And we'll come down here, turn on the windshield heat. All right, we are good to taxi. So we're going to bring the propellers up to low RPM. You can hear them spooling up, they're coming out of feather. There we go. And taxi light can come on. We're going to be taking off on runway 11. We're going to have about a 2-knot tailwind, but that's fine. It'll be runway 11, and then we'll be off on our departure. And we'll be good to go. I'm just going to wheel around these guys here, so we're not playing around without trying to push us. We'll go around the power cart. Now watch your heads, guys. Take taxiway Alpha over here. And again, it's a very light tailwind, nothing too major to worry about. Brakes are set. We're going to bring the propellers fully forward into high RPM. Auto feather is armed. We are going to put the anti-ice on just because of the clouds we're about to fly into. So fuel quantity is checked. Fuel boost pumps are on. Trim is set to 10%. Or 10 degrees. Flight instruments are all checked. Barrel is set. Radios are all set. Transponder will go to out. Propellers are fully forward. That's confirmed. Auto feather is on. Instruments are set, pitot heat is on, anti-ice is on, flight controls are free and correct, transponder is on, out, landing lights are on, caution lights, that's just because we're down in idle, and we are on the correct runway. Brake release, we'll move out now. Ourselves out into position. There's the other guys. All right. So we are set. Bringing the engines up. It's 20 inches. Brakes released. Going to 40 inches for takeoff. It's 40 knots, 50 knots, 60 knots. And we're up. Climb going. It's roughly 500 feet. Flaps coming up. So we'll go autopilot on. We're going to go to nav mode. And 1600 feet per minute. Bring the engines up to 45. And props back to 90.
Three.
There we go. Turning before the mountains. We're gonna head to the north now. The northeast. So, climb checks. Flaps are up. Auto feather is off. Climb power 45 and 90 on the propellers is set. Landing lights come off. Taxi light is off. And then we'll leave the de-ice on until we're through the clouds. Nick's up, and there goes Kevin. Very nice. A little bit of ice forming on the wiper blades. But we do have the anti-ice going, so we're good there. So, this is the last flight in the Twin Otter for the Norway tour, and for a little while, but she will be back. Have some other trips planned for her, but we're going to put her in the hangar for a little bit, fly some other airplanes, and then we will get back to her though, because she is a fun airplane to fly. We're getting up to the top of the clouds here. Nice little breakout. Actually, what we should probably do is get some inside views. We don't do that this often in the airplane. definitely a lot nicer above the clouds. So we'll jump back up, just check our power settings. We want to keep it at 45. So as we climb, we're going to have to keep adding power. Through the clouds, we can turn off the boots, but we'll leave the rest of it on auto. Then we'll change our barrel over to standard now. To go. Pass through 10,000 feet, and we can put a little bit of music on. It is noisy in this airplane, so not sure how well it'll come across. Map up so everyone can follow along. And if anyone's wondering, the airport we took off of at Alta is almost 70 degrees north. 69.58.6. So we're getting pretty far up into the north.
I drove my wife to the hospital in this car. Indeed, my daughter was born.
This man took our family on some of the best and worst road trips. Every vehicle holds memories, which makes saying goodbye tough. Give your car a legacy to remember. Donate it to Kidney Car. Your donation will help Canadians living with kidney disease, and that's a memory you can cherish. Kidney Car.
that power up.
You know which flag is the best? The Honda checkered flag. That one helps you find the all-new 2022 Honda Civic. You know, North American car of the year. Ajax 2022 Canadian.
So the power levers are now pushed fully forward. We're going to see, as we keep this ascending, we're going to see a slight drop off in power continue.
For 60 months, 1875 down tax extra. Anticipated delivery late spring 2022. See HondaOntario.com.
SDA, they want us above flight level 1100 or 110. And that's for the approach and arrival. Well, we got 40 miles basically to get out to the release point on the star, 1,000 feet to go, and we have to be 3,000 feet by then. So we got, we can stay at 19,000 until I think SDA, and then we'll head downwards. All right, there's 19,000 coming up. Your power is now below 40 inches. So our climb rate's down to just a couple hundred feet, so we're going to bring the propellers back to cruise mode, which is 76%. Hear the engine sound change. Go. We're now in cruise. And we're going to bring the power back now to 40. So 40 inches of torque pressure, 76% on the props. We are in cruise power. We've got about 72 miles to our top of descent. You are, Kevin? Oh, man. I haven't gotten any. I didn't get any yesterday. Nor those pesky, internet's disconnected and then you're connected again messages either. And everything's looking good today. Where the other guys are if they climbed all the way up. Oh, Kevin did. As per normal, Nick is down a little bit lower. Sightseeing. Kevin's actually pretty close. Don't go outside too much, it's very, very noisy out there. Yeah, well, you'll see if it pops up on my screen, but I don't think... after yesterday having no issues, I think that's kind of resolved, but we'll see. So we are going to have to tune in the ILS frequency. I don't know. It's strange, Nick. If that's what Simsbury's given you, because it's always giving me 1900, or 1900, 19,000. Anyway, the arrival information. We're going to be coming in from the northwest down here to Do God. And then we're going to fly down to Unden and in for the fix. You can see FF23, which is where we're going to intercept. We got to be at 2900. So it's 3,000 by Duguid, which is fine. We can do that. ILS frequency is 110.3. So we come over here and on ILS 1, which is the one we're going to want for the ILS. Let's just flip you and 1103. And there we go. So that's now set. Quickly going to see if there's anything else out here. There's not even a NDB. Well, no. Well, there is 342, and then I'll show you where it is. Well, 3, 2, and 4. 342. All right. So it is located. Just north of the airport, up here. So it's located up here in Vadso. So we put it in just as a cross-reference point, but it's really not going to give us much information because there's very few nav aids out this way. It's all GPS. I already got rid of that. That's good. Oh, there goes Kevin. That's a little rather close for formation flying. I think the passengers might get a little upset by seeing that.
Yes.
Oh, you're approved. See, I thought, never mind.
Hear that, kids? Finally.
There you are back there.
Go to alpinecredits.ca to get started. Some conditions apply.
It's your license, 12616. Vogue Optical wants to give you 3 pairs of glasses.
Well, you got to admit, it made for an interesting view out the front window.
Just bring in your prescription, purchase your first pair, get your second pair for free.
All right, so we're going to tune in the same frequency down on nav 2 of 110.3.
Absolutely free. 3 for the price of 1. Wow. Hurry into Vogue Optical today for details.
No, that's comms.
Only for a limited time.
And that will give us our second one here. We'll read it as well. are doing good. See, we do have a bit of a crab going on here. It's what? Almost 10, 20, almost 25 degree crab. And our ground speed showing 145 with our airspeed of about 130. So we're not getting a, really getting a push today. Winds currently at our destination at Kirkenes is 260 at 6. We're landing on runway 23. We're doing the ILS for runway 23. Just monitoring. So tomorrow we're going to be I'm going to be redoing the Tokyo to Guam flight. As you may remember, for some reason the OBS ingestion servers went down and that killed the stream. So I wasn't able to do the flight because I had stopped and I was troubleshooting, and that's what I tracked it down to. So tomorrow I'll be redoing it. For those of you who did fly it already, I'm not going to ask you to fly it again. If you want to come along, that's great. Just hang in the chat, that's great as well. But tomorrow we'll be doing the Pan Am flight. And it'll be Tokyo to Guam. And we've got the sad news that that's the last Pan Am flight on Sundays. The following week, it will be moving to Saturdays. And it will run Saturdays for the rest of its series. As come mid-May, my Sundays will be taken up and I won't be streaming. So just going to shift it over, and until my schedule books up on the Sundays, we'll be doing some long haul flights on Sundays just to fill the stream space. So dust off your A330s or A340s and your 777s and 747s. We're going to do some long haul passenger flights. I think we're going to base out of the UK for those. So it'll be good to do some flying out of London Heathrow again. We'll start with a reasonably short one and then we'll work our way up. But I found the 747 with the updated salty mod to be pretty good and reliable. So we'll be doing that. And there will be VAT sim flights as well, so we can get ATC involved and have all the funds. Cold is still lingering. A little bit of a stuffy nose and a bit of a sore throat. Just won't clear away. Alright, so we're about 43 miles from our top of descent. Bad views. It's a scattered cloud, but we can see the ground. Get some views of the terrain up here. A lot of little lakes and stuff. Well, it'll be all frozen over still. After SDA, we'll be turning and basically heading down a fjord, so that allows us to descend right down to 3,000. It's going to be a fairly gentle descent, though. Watch the clouds closely in front of us. You can see us slightly skidding to the right. That's the wind drift that we're crabbing to account for. Once we start down, I'll grab the current weather for Kirkenes, and we'll get our barrel, double check our winds. Checking all our gauges, everything is looking good. for the airport, we have a Class A, B minimums. 532 feet. So what we can do is come down and set that up. Down here. So that's 500 and 600. So that's 550. We'll go to right about there. Actually, we'll go one click over just to err on the higher elevation. So that's about 550. So that's our minimum set for the arrival. Mic for about 2 minutes and I'll be back, and we should be about ready to begin our descent on the arrival. So see you in a couple.
A memory you can share.
there's nothing wrong with getting excited for a long-awaited feast with friends. But if you get a little carried away, Pepto-Bismol Liquid Caps is your handy on-the-go pack that offers fast, soothing relief for upset stomachs, so you can continue with your day worry-free. Get effective relief with Pepto-Bismol Liquid Caps. To ensure this product is right for you, always read and follow the label. Keep out of the reach of children.
That's what we need, Pepto-Bismol after my eggs. Airplane eggs. 17 miles to go. It's getting beautiful views of Norway, northern Norway. We're way up, pretty close to the Arctic Circle. South towards Sweden right now. We're coming over the top of Sweden. That's why our course took us up on the kind of northeast, and then we go southwest down to the airport, just avoiding Swedish airspace. I think it's Sweden and not Finland. Let me take a look. No, I stand corrected. It is Finnish airspace. So we're looking down towards Finland, land of the reindeers. Kevin's still there. Not seeing Nick. Unfortunately, you don't know what that means. Well, this is a celebration flight. It's the last of the tour. Nick, I hope everything's well and you're still going. And this is just the multiplayer bug making you vanish. So at KR530, we do have a maximum or a minimum altitude of 11,000 feet, so that's what we're going to set as our initial descent altitude until we pass that point. You're still here? Okay, great. Oh, I know what a rave is. It's used over here as well. That's what I mean. It's the last flight. We're having a party in the back. All the flashing disco lights and everything. Our destination airport is actually, let's see, down about here. We're going to turn about here and we're going to come down this fjord that we can see here in the map, and then down and in. So we'll set the 11,000. We'll go down, we got 14 miles. It's 8,000 feet to lose. We'll go down at about 1,200 feet per minute. Runway heading 233. I'm going to dial this guy over to 233. About there. And once we go to VLOC, we'll dial this one over to 233 as well. This is live weather, live time, so we're actually seeing what it's like up here in northern Norway at the moment. We're under a mile out from the waypoint, so anytime now we should get the flip. There we go. And we can start down now at, like I said, we'll go down at about 1,200 feet per minute. We'll bring the power back to 30 inches just so that we don't accelerate downhill. And a half miles out from KR530. That's an 11,000 foot minimum altitude.
also mean you can eat anything you get delivered. From groceries to alcohol, there's so much more. Uber Eats, get anything. Don't always eat it. Not literally anything. Item availability varies by market. Alcohol in select cities only. Must be of legal drinking age to purchase alcohol. See app for details.
Savor everyday moments with Virtual by Nespresso. Enjoy your favorite morning long cup or simply explore a variety of coffee styles. It all starts with the touch of a button. Virtual by Nespresso. Make your everyday extraordinary.
Oh, I just realized I've been on mute for the last while. And none of you guys told me. Wow. Anyway, we are on our descent. We're coming up for 10,000 feet. So we're going to throw on the landing lights. We'll throw the taxi light on as well. I am going to throw the anti-ice on because we're heading for the clouds, and the outside air temperature is about minus 12 or 13 degrees. We're now heading down the fjord, as you can see on the map, which is all frozen. There's the town. The airport's just over here, so we're going to come down, and then we'll loop around and then in. NDB is now pointing to Vadso. You can see the arrow pointing away there, and we are picking up the localizer frequency, and it's showing yes, we are to the left, which is correct. As I put in the chat, the weather is currently 250 at 9, broken at 3600, 2 degrees, QNH 1024, and 731 feet, the winds are 260 at 20, so it's a bit more windy as we come in, and we're going to set our barometer now, 1024. There we go, and we're going to monitor, we're leaving it at 1200 feet per minute at the moment. It's giving us a nice descent rate, and we're headed down to 3000 feet, and there's Nick off to the side. We should be on the ground in about 15 minutes. Everything is looking good. Just watching the power as we descend, come up a little bit. Let's make sure we keep that 30 inches. At a good speed now, 160 knots. I think we are set for our arrival. 7,500 feet. We're basically out over the water at the moment. From the clouds. So we're under 7,000 feet, so we'll go a bit of a sterile cockpit, turn off the radio, monitor self down. We've got 21 miles to go to do good. So we should come out of the clouds and be just below the clouds as we level off. Feet to go. I'm going to bring that down to 1,000 feet now. Keep the power at 30 inches. Just don't want to be coming down on too steep a descent rate through the clouds. So we've always got the radar altimeter to show below if we need anything. Minimum 2,500 feet above the ground at the moment, so or any terrain features. It's 5,000 feet. Looking very rough over there. A little bit of ice starting to appear on the wipers. Thousand to go. I think we know where we're going now, in and around, and then landing at the airport, so we can get rid of the map here. Just maintain our concentration as we come in. Good view of all the instruments. We're almost to beam the NDB over at VADSO. The charts are showing a 112.0. Let's put that on the second one. See if we pick that one up. Yep, we are. Okay. So there is a VOR or some sort of beacon there anyway. It's not the ILS. It's 3,000 feet. We'll bring the power back up to 40 inches for our cruise. Yeah, looks like we're popping in and out of the clouds here. Weather radar here is what you see is what you get. Oh, does it? Well, that's pretty cool. Morse identifier nav too. I think I can faintly hear it. I'm gonna leave that on, see if it gets stronger as we get closer. Should be beeping. KIK. Dash dot dash dot dot dash dot dash. Yeah, I think I can faintly hear it. So there's the water. We've come out of the frozen section. out towards more open water, so the ice is broken up. Yeah, I can definitely hear it. Do good is 3,000, and we're going to drop down to 2,900, which will be for the intercept. See that NDB is well behind us now. There's Nick. 2.5 miles out from Dugard. Hear the Kirkenes beacon. Faintly in the background there. We'll set 2,900. And there's the turn. So there we are, 2,900. Yeah, I noticed some terrain glitching. I don't know if you guys can hear the marker audio signal. No, I can hear it anyway. I'm gonna turn it off now. There's that spike. Some weird terrain stuff going on. Alright, so we're going to go over to heading mode now, and then we're going to go into VLOC. We're going to dial IS over to 223. Definitely some weird terrain stuff going on. There we go. Alright, so we're coming in now. We're going to go to approach mode. There we are, swinging around. Props are going fully forward. turn off all the proactive anti-ice. We'll leave the automatic stuff on. Swing around those weird terrain spikes. There's the airport. I'll give Nick a little bit of room, so I'm going to start slowing up a bit. Bring my power back to about 30 inches of torque. So cabin's been notified, landing lights are on. Fuel quantity's been checked, all the caution lights are on that we need. Altimeters are set, signs are on. And as I mentioned, landing lights are set. Bring the power back to 25 inches. So when we land, it's going to be a left-hand departure, and we'll be parking up at the terminal, taking either taxiway Charlie, and then pulling in there. Yeah, terminal, Nick. So bring the power right back, 10 inches. There's the glide slope. It's coming back to 5 inches. Just 95 knots, flaps 1. Try to keep the speed around 90. So about 750 feet, the winds are going to be twice as strong as they will be on the ground. And flaps too. Speed's back to 80. That's where we're going to hold it. And flaps 3, which is 30 degrees. Landing flaps. We're over the outer marker. Although why it flashes inner, I don't know. See, we're still crabbing here. I'm going to turn our heading over to basically the direction we're going, runway, in case we got to go around. Well, Kevin, you never know. There's some weird things happening in Norway. Sir Oki could tell us all about it. And thanks for the follow there over on Twitch. I heard the sound. I was looking at the panel and waiting to see if anything pops up on the screen. There it is. NDN Puppet, thank you very much for the follow. And hello. You're joining us at the end of the flight, unfortunately. We're just coming into land, as you can see. We're getting a little slow. We'll get the speed back up to about 75 to 80. 80 would be preferred. Well, it's been a good flight, a little cloudy. We got to see some of the ground down there. Thank you for that update, Nick. Everything is looking good. Alright, let's see our full panel there. Airport elevation is 284 feet. So we're about 1,000 feet to go. We got some hills here that we're going to be coming over. It might trigger the minimums early. Alright, 1,000 feet to go. Oh, we're at 1,000 feet. We're about 700 feet above the ground. I'm going to take over.
Minimums.
Landing. Get ourselves a little bit better lined up. There we go. Displaced threshold, as we can see, so we're going to aim for the touchdown zone. Slightly below the glide. Flatten her out slightly. So bring the power back. Little bounce. There we go. Nose wheel is down. And we're gonna roll up to Charlie and then exit. Park over by Nick there. So that's us down. And we are clear of the active runway. Alright, so flaps can come up. Landing lights off. Transponder to standby. Props back into minimum RPM. Parking spot 24. Its parking brakes are set. Power levers are fully back. Props are going into feather. Generators are off. Let those props come back. There they are. Now shut them down. The fuel levers are off. Fuel boost pumps can come off. And we'll kill all the lights. Alright, so first one I'm going to do is windshield heat can come off. We'll go back up here. So anti-ice can come off. We can disarm the emergency lights. All these lights can come off. We'll put the entrance light on so everyone can get out. Taxi light off. Pitot heat's off. Heating is back to manual. Flight compartment fans and strobes are off. Windshield heat is off. Turn off that one. Master's off and the battery is off. So that's us here parked up. And Kevin has just pulled in beside us. And there we are. Well, thank you guys very much for flying along with us. And thanks for watching. That ends our tour of Norway. We made it all the way up to the top. Hope to see you again on the next flight. Next Friday, we start our business jet series. And we'll be down in New Zealand to start that off. So thank you again for joining us. Hope you have a great day. We'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.